Hello guys, what's up? This is Sir EG and welcome for another Grade 9 math tutorial. In today's topic, we will be discussing the parts of a right triangle. Let's have the following objectives in today's topic. Letter A, identify the parts of a right triangle. Letter B, be familiar with the definition of a right triangle and its parts. And letter C, value accumulated knowledge as means of new understanding. So this given figure is an example of right triangle. When we say right triangle, it is a type of triangle which has one right angle. So the measure of a right angle is equal to 90 degrees. It can only have one right angle. So in a right triangle, there is only one right angle because the total measure of degrees in a triangle is equal to 180. So if it had two right angles, then those two angles would take off all 180 degrees because 90 degrees plus 90 degrees will be equal to 180 degrees. So no degrees would be left for a third angle. So remember, in a right triangle, there is only one right angle and the other two angles share the remaining 90 degrees. So the two angles are both acute angles. So let's identify the parts of a right triangle. So we have triangle ABC in which angle B has a right angle. So angle B is equal to 90 degrees. Then let's identify the hypotenuse. So to identify the hypotenuse or the longest side of a right triangle, we will look at our right angle. The opposite side of the right angle is the hypotenuse of the right triangle. So the longest side of our right triangle is segment AC. So this will be our hypotenuse. Now, after we have identified the hypotenuse, these two sides of the right triangle, side BC and side AB, is called the legs. So it can be the shorter leg or the longer leg depending on the measure of the right triangle. But this is basically called the legs of the right triangle. Now, we can actually get further into this by differentiating these two legs depending on what angle we are talking about. Say, for example, we are talking about angle C. So the given angle is angle C. So the side in between the given angle and the right angle is called the adjacent side. So this side, side BC, is the adjacent side. And then this one, the opposite side of angle C, which is segment AB, will be the opposite side. So segment AB is the opposite side if the given angle is angle C. Now, how about if the given angle is angle A? So if the given angle is angle A, so the side in between angle A and the right angle will now be the adjacent side. And the side which is opposite of angle A will be the opposite side. So segment BC will be the opposite side. So that's how we identify the parts of a right triangle. So let's have this example. Identify the parts of the right triangle XYZ. So we have a given right angle here. So angle Z is equal to 90 degrees. So first, let's identify the hypotenuse of triangle XYZ. So the opposite side of the right angle is segment XY. So this will be the longest side of the right triangle, the hypotenuse. After that, let's now identify the adjacent side of angle X. So if the given angle is angle X, so the angle in between angle X and the right angle will be the adjacent side. So the adjacent side will be segment XZ. Now, let's identify the opposite side of angle X. So, the opposite side of angle X is this one. So, segment YZ or segment ZY. Next, let's identify the adjacent side of angle Y. So, this one. So, angle Y now will be our given angle. The side in between angle Y and angle C, which is the right angle, is the adjacent side. So, the adjacent side now will be segment YZ. Then, for the opposite side of angle Y, so we will look at our opposite side. So, our opposite side will be segment XZ. So, let's solve our last example. Identify the parts of the right triangle EJM. So, the given right angle is at angle J, which is equal to 90 degrees. Let's find the hypotenuse of triangle EJM. So, to find the hypotenuse of triangle EJM, we will look at the opposite side of our right angle, and that is segment EM or segment ME. Next, let's look for the adjacent side of angle E if angle E is our given angle. So, to look for the adjacent side, it is the side which is in between angle E and the right angle. So, the adjacent side will be segment EJ or segment JE. Then, for the opposite side of angle E, so this one will be the opposite side. So, segment JM will be the opposite side of angle E. Now, let's look for the adjacent side of angle M if angle M is the given angle. So, the adjacent side is the side in between the given angle and the right angle. So, the adjacent side is equal to segment GM. And for the opposite side of angle M, we will look for the opposite side of angle M, and that is segment JE or segment EJ. So, that's how we can identify the parts of a right triangle.